Hi everyone, I'm Jennifer Corey with Heart Initiative, and here's this week's episode of Good Hearted News. It is Sunday, May 10th, Mother's Day, in over 100 countries around the world. So guess what? Here's something else that we share in common globally, and it's not a pandemic, and it's Mother's Day. So from Canada and Colombia and Denmark to Zimbabwe, and Mexico, and the United States, and every place in between, we want to recognize mothers and thank you for all that you do and wish you all an absolutely wonderful Mother's Day. We also want to share a couple of stories and videos that we found this week that we are sharing with you to inspire you, to elevate you, to bring you some humor, and most of all, to remind you of all of the good that happens, even in the middle of a pandemic, even in the middle of struggles and difficulties and trying times that we have in our lives. So it's not meant to ignore the difficulties and the struggles, but it is meant to remind you that that's not all that's happening. And so here is some news that is both good and good for you. Let's start with the British artist and poet by the name of Tom Foolery, who tells a tale called The Great Realization, which is a beautiful poem that he disguises as a children's story. It is a video. It is so moving and so touching and so powerful. And if you have children, I encourage you to watch it with them. If you still are a child at heart, and even if you're not, please watch this and prepare to be moved. The link will be below. We're sharing with you a beautiful news story about Emerson Weber, who is an 11-year-old girl who uses the U.S. Postal Service to stay connected to all sorts of friends and buddies by writing letters and mailing them through the Postal Service. And she decided to write a letter of thanks and gratitude to her postal worker. And he was so touched by it that he shared it with his boss, who then shared it throughout the whole Postal Service, the U.S. Postal Service. And she has received thousands of letters from postal workers thanking her for her recognition. And it's a really touching and lovely story. So we hope you share that. We also have a story in there from the Wall Street Journal about surprising ways to stay resilient and how gratitude is really the key to resilience, something you already know. But for some people, until you read it in the Wall Street Journal, it may not feel like it's relevant enough. And so we hope that you enjoy the article. We certainly did. There's a video that we're sharing by the memoirist Kelly Corrigan. If you haven't read any of her work, she's so incredibly talented. But she created a video in which she shares a story about how she uses something fantasy scenarios of how to be able to navigate a time, or how she has navigated a time and really nailed it. And she shares this technique that she uses for the rest of us to be able to use during this time of COVID. And it's a wonderful story and an illustration of how to be able to use a process called best case scenario thinking, which is a psychological practice that we use, but really to see how somebody just is using it in their everyday life. And she's such a good storyteller that I think you will enjoy it. The humor piece of the week that we're sharing is a rap done by Wes Tank. And he is rapping Dr. Seuss book, Fox in Socks, over a Dr. Dre beat. And the guy is so talented and it is so good. And I've watched it repeatedly. I can't seem to stop watching it. So I hope that you enjoy it as much as I have. He is really talented and it's just really, it's really great. And finally, our song of the week is Barbra Streisand's You Will Never Walk Alone. You might remember this because she released this song after 9/11. It was touching then and it's incredibly touching now. She's re-released it in honor of the first responders, physicians, nurses, janitors, hospital reception staff, the cooks and food service workers, delivery workers and postal service people and, you know, everybody, cashiers and everybody who is really helping to keep our world moving forward and going, and who's helping to give hope. So it's a beautiful song and it has a beautiful new video to go with it. So we hope that you enjoy it. And above all, Above all, we want to remind you, there's so much more good than there is difficulty, even at these times. And we just want to help orient you towards some of that. So we wish you a wonderful Sunday, blessed Mother's Day, and good health.